Selam.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Eşhedü en la ilahe illallah. Eşhedü en la ilahe illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئًا أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وإن أحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار إخوتي الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, just few days back, we were talking about welcoming a guest, the most important guest of the year. We were talking that how we should receive this blessed month of Ramadan, this special guest. What ikram should we do? What are the etiquettes when that guest will be with us? And we were talking about that. And today, we are saying that this is the last Friday of the month of Ramadan. The question is, brothers and sisters, where do we stand after these 24 or 25 days of the month of Ramadan are gone? Where we stand in terms of our relationship with Allah, ta'alluq billah, this guest of the month of Ramadan is with us from last 24 or 25 days. There were certain demands and objectives that we were asked to achieve from this blessed month of Ramadan. The reason we have that huzn, the reason we should feel the pain that this month of Ramadan is leaving us, because we don't have, none of us should have surety that we are going to be alive, we are going to, you know, witness this blessed month of Ramadan again or not. This month of Ramadan is an opportunity for all of us, for our sins to be forgiven, to be among those who will be forgiven by the end of this blessed month of Ramadan. This month of Ramadan, the door of mercy, it is open. The door of Jannah is wide open. And we were talking about it. Brothers and sisters, whenever we have any ni'mah from Allah, it comes with responsibility. This month of Ramadan was or is a ni'mah from Allah. Allah bless me and you with a life to observe this month of Ramadan. And Allah is going to ask, O my slave, how did you spend your month of Ramadan when I blessed you with a life? So today, standing here and sitting there, we really need to observe ourselves. We need to have the critical analysis of ourselves. Where do we stand after these many days, and we have few seconds left in the month of Ramadan? It tells us, because as we were mentioning, Ramadan will come and will go without us waking up enough. And this is what happened. It shows us, brothers and sisters, the value of time. This is how our life will also pass. If our life is now average 40 years, and if I ask you to tell me what did you do in your life, maybe we will summarize our whole 40 years in 10-15 minutes. 10-15 minutes. This is what we spent. 40 years and we can summarize it. And on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say that there will be a conversation for how long we lived in this life. There will be a conversation. As Allah mentioned in one of the surah Ash-Shu'ara, قَالَ كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْضَ يَوْمٍ فَاسْأَلِ الْعَادِّينَ قَالَ إِنْ لَبِثْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. For how many years do you think you lived in this world? So they will say, a day, or part of the day. And when they will ask someone else, they will say, illa biftum illa qalila. Not even that. We were just in this world for a very short, for few moments. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So this month of Ramadan teaches us, brothers and sisters, the value of time. Month of Ramadan is there. Still we have few days. If we could not do enough, if we are not satisfied, and even if we are thinking that Alhamdulillah we did enough, we are up to the mark. Still make sure that these remaining few seconds, remaining few hours of the month of Ramadan, we pass them, we utilize them in a way that inshaAllah, at the end, our name will be in the list in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I'm going to, you know, عُتَطَاءُ مِنَ النَّارِ. They will be forgiven in the month of Ramadan. Still we have time. Still the gates of the Jannah are open. Still the gate of Maghfirah are open, are wide open. Still we have a chance, brothers and sisters. Still. And what we can do, the best, one of the best dhikr that we can do in these remaining hours is what Aisha radiallahu anha, when she asked about Laylatul Qadr. And she was told, make this dua. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. And you know, brothers and sisters, what is the difference between a maghfirah and afuf? Why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not use the word maghfirah here? What's the difference between afu and maghfirah? Maghfirah is that when we ask for maghfirah from Allah, that sin remains in the book of deed, and we will see it on the day of judgment, although we will not be questioned about it because we repented, but it will be in our book of deed. But the afu is subhanallah, that whatever sin you are repenting of, it will be wiped off completely from the book of deed. Allahu Akbar. That's why we say, Allahumma innaka afu. Oh Allah, indeed you are the one who forgives. You are the one who erased those sins completely. تُحِبُّ الْعَفْءِ. You love forgiveness. Rasulullah ﷺ said, كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّاءٌ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابِينَ. Every, you know, son of Adam is sinner. But the best of the sinners are those who repent, who come back to Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in one of the meaning of the hadith, becomes angry to that person who does not ask him, who does not ask for, you know, tawbah to him. So that's why he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تُحِبُّ الْعَفْءِ. Oh Allah, you love forgiveness. فَعْفُ عَنِّي. So please forgive me. Please forgive me. So this one of the lessons that we get when we see, when we look back, it seems to be 24 or 25 days, but it seems that there were just few moments. So it teaches us the value of time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned one of the hadith, ni'matan. There are two ni'mah, two blessings, that majority of the people, they don't take heed, they don't care about that, those two ni'mah, those two bounties, that much. And ni'mah is sihha wal faragh, the health and the free time, the time. In the month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah, we saw what we can do, how much we can do. We felt, you know, an attachment with the house of Allah. We felt an attachment with each other even. With each other even. Most of us, we were seeing each other almost every day, every day. One of the brothers just before Salah was mentioning that, I love you, brother. Why? And we were talking and I said, أُحِبُّكَ فِي اللَّهِ. We love you, we love each other for the sake of Allah. So when we are coming to the house of Allah, one of the another lesson that we learned in the month of Ramadan, that we were seeing each other, we were greeting each other. If any brother was missing, we were saying, we were talking about him. Today he didn't come for iftar, he didn't come for taraweeh. And this is the essence of Salah. This is the essence of Salah. The last glimpse that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had for of this ummah was when? In what state? As one of the Sahabi is saying, the last time when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw this ummah, his ummah, was that they were standing in one line and they were praying, and he smiled. He removed his curtain and he saw the Sahaba, they were standing in one line and praying and smiled, and he went back, and after that he didn't come out. So they have that interpretation why he was smiling, because the whole of his effort, 23 years of effort, It seemed that the reason he smiled, this is what he got. He achieved his objective. Muslims standing in one line, regardless of any race, regardless of any nationality. They're standing in one line, praying to one God. And that unity. That unity. And he smiled, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And wallahi, if we continue that, you will see where we will be. If we continue to see the Muslims, they are attached to the house of Allah Azza wa Jal the way we are in the month of Ramadan, wallahi, things will change all over the world. The reason we are suffering is because we are away from Allah. We are away not only from Allah, we are away from the houses of Allah. We are away from the houses of Allah. Baytullah, Baytullah. In which when we come, who is our host? Allah. And we are the guest of Allah. But sometimes we miss that. So month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters, is leaving. The special guest that we have is going to leave us in a few seconds. A couple of points that I would like to mention. How to say goodbye to the month of Ramadan. And this is very, very important. In our deen, we are taught that each deed that we do should be concluded with istighfar. You know, when we end the salah, what's the first word that we utter from our word? What Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say? Astaghfirullah. Why? Because none of us can say my salah was complete. That's why we say astaghfirullah, wallah, please forgive me if there was any shortcoming. Hajj is concluded again with the dhikr of Allah. Astaghfirullah. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. All the ibadah in our religion concludes with istighfar. So let's say farewell to the month of Ramadan with istighfar, with lot of dua, with lot of istighfar. And the best, as we said, Allahumma innaka afuwun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Make this dua to Allah, O Allah. If there was any shortcoming, O Allah, just forgive me. So this is one thing that we need to make sure when we are saying farewell to the month of Ramadan, we have to say goodbye in this way. Second thing, and that is also very important. I'm going to mention just two points. I already mentioned one. The second is, brothers and sisters, the moment we know, the moment we realize that khalas, today is the last day of the month of Ramadan, what happens in Maghrib? That most of us, khalas, we feel that there was something that was going on and now I'm relief of it. Nowadays, alhamdulillah, we see in our weekday iftar also, we have more than maybe our average 50 people coming. But what we observed in previous years, that we have just few brothers, the picture looks completely different. Right, even, you know, few moments that we said, maybe not even complete goodbye to the month of Ramadan, and we see a flip side of the coin. Do you think this is what... If we have any dignity in our house, any special guest in our house, and still he is in the door, he is standing at the door, and we are busy in something else. We sometime, may Allah forgive us, start even, you know, disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal. On the name of Chandrat, or the Eid night, we need to be very, very careful, brothers and sisters. We spend the whole month in the ibadah, in the worship of Allah. And right away when that guest is leaving, and if we start again, I'm not saying there is a harm that in preparing for the Eid, but it should not lead us to be, you know, disobedient servant of Allah. We should not miss Maghrib prayer. We should not miss Isha prayer. But sometimes it happens. In the month of Ramadan, we are making sure that we are praying Isha in the masjid. We need to do the same thing. on the first day of Shawwal. Then we will see, then we can say yes, the month of Ramadan has a positive impact on me. Because you and me, we sacrifice a lot in the month of Ramadan. We had to reschedule our schedule to be here in the house of Allah. We had to reschedule our schedule to do those things that we normally we don't do. Still our dunya was fine. Still everything was going completely fine. But it shows us that we can be champions. We can do a lot better inshallah even after the month of Ramadan. Because the Rabb of Ramadan is not only the Rabb of Ramadan only. He is the Rabb of the whole, you know, 365 days. So please make sure that we are saying, if Allah gives us life, the farewell to the month of Ramadan, and we are in the first day of Shawwal, that will be our test. Because the devils will be, they are chained, not chained up, right? Now when they will be out, what do you think what they are going to do with us? Those slaves of Allah who were closer to Deen, who came closer to Allah, now their first job will be to make sure to keep them away from Allah. And the first attack that they will have will be your salah. Not praying in jama'ah, not praying properly and on time. That will be their first attack. And the second will be the day of Eid. We need to make sure, brother and sister, the day of Eid is a day of celebration. So when we are celebrating that Eid, see how we start our celebration. In Islam, all these celebrations are attached with the worship. Nikah is done with the khutbah of Nikah. The celebration of the best day of the week, Jum'ah, we have a special ibadah, the khutbah, and special worship, special, you know, prayer. Likewise, the Eid, the day of celebration starts with worship. So Allah wants us to realize, oh my slave, don't forget that. You are a Muslim. And that's how you have to celebrate. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those, inshallah, who will be forgiven by the end of the month of Ramadan. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our qiyam, our rukur, our sujood, our tilawa of Quran, our sadaqat, whatever we did in this blessed month of Ramadan, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. Oh Allah, we know there were a lot of shortcomings, but your rahmah is wasi'at kulla shay. We are not asking for forgiveness based on our deeds, based on what little bit we did in the month of Ramadan. No, ya Allah, we are asking it through your rahmah. Don't judge us based on our a'mal, but we are looking for your mercy, O Allah. Based on your rahmah, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bless each one of us. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept from each one of us. Inshallah, make us, all of us, inshallah, among those who will be forgiven. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha, wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Astaghfiruhu innahu wal ghafur rahim. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. We conclude the khutbah with three points, brothers and sisters, that we need to do in these next few days. One is Zakatul Fitr. Zakatul Fitr, the analogy that the scholar they give is just like the Sajda Suhuf in Salah. We do Sajda Suhuf when there is a mistake in the Salah. So Zakatul Fitr, Fitrana, or Sadaqatul Fitr is Sajda Suhuf to the month of Ramadan, to the fasting that we do. So there are two objectives of Zakatul Fitr. One is that if there was any shortcoming in our fasting, so we are paying that money or giving that one sa'ah just to make up, or if there's any shortcoming, we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness through that. And the second objective is to give that, to deliver that money to those people who can also enjoy the Eid day. So make sure that you are paying your zakat al-fitr. The max period is the before the Salatul Eid, but don't delay it. If you are paying on time, it will reach to those families, those people, those brothers and sisters, those children on time, and they will also be able to enjoy the Eid day, inshallah. The second thing is, after the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah said about the hadith that من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال كصيام الدهر. Alhamdulillah, we have a habit to fast in the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah said, if a person fasts in the month of Ramadan followed by 6 days of Shawwal, it is as if he fasts for the whole year. So since we have a habit, continue it inshallah, not on Eid day, but starting from the second day of Eid. And you can, you know, you don't have to fast for the whole consecutive 6 days. You can divide it in the whole month of Shawwal. But since we have a habit, it becomes very easy to fast if we are fasting, inshallah, in the beginning of the month of Shawwal. Lastly, inshallah, we'll have the Eid. So there are few sunnah related to the Eid Salah, Eid prayer. One is the takbirat. And takbirat doesn't start that when we enter in the masjid and we join the jama'ah with the takbirat before the imam comes for the prayer. The takbirat starts right at the sunset. Right at the sunset in the last day of the month of Ramadan, which means the first day of Shawwal. After the sunset, after the Maghrib, inshallah, just say the takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. At night time, and then coming for Salatul Eid, also make sure that we are, our tongue is busy in this takbir, inshallah. The second sunnah is that to eat an odd number of dates. When coming for Salatul Eid, Rasulullah used to eat odd number of dates. But on that day, we are not fasting, right? So we have to make sure, you know, you're eating a date or anything that is sweet. Better is date. That is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wear whatever available cloth, the best cloth that are available, inshallah. And also, another sunnah is that the way you're using or to come to the masjid, to a masjid for Salatul Eid, take a different route when you're going back to your house. It is also the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam related to Eid. Let's make dua, inshallah, as this is the farewell or the last Jum'ah of the month of Ramadan. And when we are praying, inshallah, and making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal, make dua with khushur. And we never know, maybe this is the time when Allah Azza wa Jal will accept our dua, inshallah. قال الله تبارك وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك يا رب لك الحمد كما هديتنا للإسلام وعلمتنا الحكمة والقرآن اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا يا الله اللهم لا تدع لنا اللهم لا تدع لنا اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذه الجمعة المباركة اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا المسجد المبارك وفي هذا الشهر المبارك يا الله لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرتا اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرتا اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرتا ولا همّا إلا فرجتا ولا دينا إلا إلا قضيتا، ولا مبتلا إلا عافيتا، ولا كربا إلا نفستا، ولا مريضا إلا شفيتا، ولا مريضا إلا شفيتا، ولا ميتا إلا رحمتا، ولا دعاء إلا استجبتا، ولا دعاء إلا استجبتا، ولا دعاء إلا استجبتا، برحمتك ومنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أجود الأجودين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام وقام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا، فغفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام وقام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا، فغفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. اللهم اجعلنا ممن صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا، فغفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. ربنا تقبل صيامنا، ربنا تقبل صيامنا، ربنا تقبل صيامنا، ربنا تقبل قيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وتلاوتنا وصدقاتنا واعتكافنا يا أرحم الراحمين، يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى، نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى، نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى أن يجعلنا من الفائزين. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين، اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين، اللهم اجعلنا من المقبولين، اللهم اجعلنا من المقبولين، اللهم اجعلنا من المقبولين. اللهم اختم لنا شهر رمضان برضوانك، اللهم اختم لنا شهر رمضان برضوانك، اللهم اختم لنا شهر رمضان برضوانك. اللهم أعد علينا رمضان، اللهم أعد علينا رمضان. اللهم أعد علينا رمضان، ونحن في صحة وسلامة وسعة رزق وأمان. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار، اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار، اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار، اللهم أعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا من النار. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم اجعلنا، اللهم من كان منهم ميتا له في قبره مد بصره، واجمع به في دار كرامتك بغير حساب ولا عذاب. اللهم من كان منهم حيا فأطل في عمره وأحسن في عمله، واختم له ولنا بخاتمة الإحسان. يا منان ويا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا تقبل دعاءنا، ربنا تقبل دعاءنا، ربنا تقبل دعاءنا، إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا